Hello, everyone, and welcome to The Vortex, where lies and falsehoods are trapped and exposed. I'm Michael Voris, coming to you for this next week from beautiful Manila in the Philippines. We left Detroit in a blizzard and landed to a very welcome, believe me, very welcome, 82 degrees after 22 hours of flying and not a heck of a lot of sleep. We came to the Philippines because of a series of pro-life talks going on in the country's capital centering on contraception. I'm happy to say I'm one of the invited speakers to the various conferences sponsored by faithful Catholics in cooperation with their bishops who are unafraid to battle against the culture of death. Being in Manila reminds me of an event that happened here more than 30 years ago. It was the World Heavyweight Championship boxing match between Muhammad Ali and Joe Frazier that took place here in September 1975. It was a slugfest, still seen as the most brutal of all. Because of its ferocity, it was dubbed the Thrilla in Manila. It might be apropos then that another epic battle is shaping up in this capital city, another slugfest of epic proportions. But this one will have results that last much longer than some yellowed sports pages and old movies. This one is a fight to the death, physically and spiritually, and it's over contraception, which of course will ultimately mean abortion as well. In this corner, Jesus Christ and the infallible teachings of His one Holy Catholic Apostolic Church. In the other corner, Satan and all his usual allies, the secular media, Planned Parenthood, the Center for Reproductive Rights. At issue, the nation's current laws, which in general forbid or greatly restrict contraception. The Philippines is an overwhelmingly Catholic country, 85% of the population, but little by little, through the insidiousness of the secular media, movies, TV, news reporting, the creeping culture of death is getting a foothold. They've actually established what might be called a beachhead and gotten to all the right kind of people, lawmakers and celebrities. And now a legislative war of titanic proportions is being fought in the halls of the nation's government. If this all sounds like Back to the Future to you, don't be alarmed, you're right. This is the same war that happened in the United States and Europe right about the time that Ali and Frazier were pounding each other's brains out here in the Philippines back in the mid-1970s. Contraception used to be illegal in the United States, and not that long ago, certainly within living memory of many of our viewers. But in the mid-1960s, a public relations campaign that proved very effective at the end of the day was waged in the media and the courts. Eventually, the U.S. Supreme Court ruled that a right to privacy existed in the United States Constitution, which permitted married couples to use contraception. That was the camel's nose under the proverbial tent. Soon, the right to privacy was extended to unmarried couples, then a right to kill an unborn child, which resulted from failed contraception, then further extended in the 1980s and 90s to homosexuals having sex. It's a tried and true plan on the part of the secular atheist crowd. They talk about overpopulation and poverty and how large families and unintended pregnancies keep a country in economic slavery, how the poor will always be poor as long as they are getting pregnant, that the only solution is the humane one of family planning and contraception. They produce charts and graphs and enlist the help of TV and radio and newspaper journalists, all who support these positions, to lie about them and slowly, over a period of months and years of never-ending beating of that drum through TV shows and editorials and advertisements and clever marketing campaigns and news reports focusing on this poor individual's individual situation or problems and woes, through all of these methods, they slowly get into the minds of the populace who begin to believe the hype and the lies. With having planted enough doubt into people's minds, they also focus on politicians who accept money from the Planned Parenthood type groups. International pressure is brought to bear through the UN studies and recommendations and reports and committees' findings. Foreign aid by the billions is dangled in front of them to sweeten the deal. A tsunami of disinformation, propaganda, lies, money, celebrity, and glamour is presented, and soon the tide begins to turn in their favor. Once all the groundswell work has been put into place, the secularists and Planned Parenthood turn their attention to the courts and the lawmakers. The Philippines has a government system much like the U.S., with two houses, an upper and a lower, a president, and a Supreme Court. Right now, as we talk, right now, a huge battle is being waged in the lower house to pass what is called the RH Bill, Reproductive Health. coverage of it has been extensive, not only in the Philippines, but also in places like the New York Times and other Western media. Go figure. We've attached a few links to these stories and reports which detail the efforts of the anti-life crowd right over here, including the propaganda from Planned Parenthood that is widely quoted in the Philippines. Most of it lies or distortions. You can just check it out by clicking on the links here. Again, if you're a regular YouTube watcher, go to our site, realcatholictv.com, call up the Vortex for today, and click on the links. Planned Parenthood makes a handsome living off its lies, so there's no surprise that they're right here in the Philippines insinuating themselves into the lives of the people. Within the next couple of weeks, the lower house of government is expected to vote on whether to pass the RH bill and thus pave the way for contraception to become legitimate in this vastly Catholic country. Now, unlike many of their counterparts in the U.S. and Europe, the Catholic bishops here in the Philippines are speaking out strongly and loudly and boldly about the evils of contraception. Some are on record as saying that if this becomes law, they will oppose it so strongly that they themselves, the bishops, will go to jail. Talk about a night and day difference between many U.S. and European bishops and these champions of the faith. Bishops in the West barely make a peep about contraception, much less threaten to go to jail over that issue, or any issue for that fact. But the Filipino bishops have deep faith and love of our Lord and His teachings that they know that if this passes, it will all lead to exactly what we've said, homosexuality, abortion, and they do not want their people being subjected to the evils of contraception, abortion, and then homosexuality. They don't want that unleashed on them. So they're taking a stand now. We're going to be meeting with and being introduced to a number of these bishops during the coming week, and we'll be certain to send them, these heroes of the faith, all your greetings and warmest wishes and prayers for their success in the coming battle. The Ali Frazier battle can't hold a candle to this upcoming Thrilla in Manila. Keep these men and their faithful flock who are fighting hard to turn back the forces of death in your prayers. We'll have more from you, for you, all week as we report from the Philippines. God bless you. I'm Michael Voris.
Please help us keep delivering these kinds of messages that so desperately need to be heard and acted on. Join RealCatholicTV.com today as a premium subscriber. Become immersed in the faith established by Jesus Christ. The Catholic Church is the only hope against evil because that is its God-given mission. As our Lord said, apart from me, you can do nothing. Join RealCatholicTV.com today as a premium subscriber and come to learn and love Christ more deeply.